Track referencing is a very common practice in both mixing and mastering that helps ensure that a track you're working on is headed in the right direction. In this video, we'll show you ways to compare and contrast your music to reference tracks quickly and intelligently, using tools like iZotope's Ozone 9 and the updated Tonal Balance Control. Oftentimes, musicians will have songs, albums, or artists that they want their music to sound like. It could be as specific a directive as requesting their music sound like a popular producer's, or as general as, I want the bass to sound loud and clear. Track referencing is a way for audio engineers to compare and contrast the songs they are mixing and mastering to songs of a similar genre and style in order to achieve the artist's vision of how it should sound by specifically comparing things like frequency response and dynamic range. A reference track's dynamic range and sonic character can be used to communicate what sound you're aiming for in your mix or master. It's important to understand how the reference's sonic profile compares to your own for several reasons. Comparing your master with a reference will help with translation issues across listening environments. If you're familiar with the concept of the car test, you know that your final product doesn't always sound the way you'd like it to on different speakers. Understanding how a reference and your own track differ on different listening environments will help you shape a better master. Having a reference track to listen to can also help you avoid losing perspective while mixing or mastering. If you're listening to your track for too long, your ears can adjust to unwanted frequencies, like high frequency buildup, for example. Switching to your reference can quickly expose these differences and provide a much needed reset. Be sure to check out this Spotify playlist by iZotope Education Director and Professional Mastering Engineer, Jonathan Weiner. Check the video details for a link. Now that we've set the table, let's jump into practical ways to compare and contrast your music to reference tracks quickly and intelligently. In both the standalone and plugin application versions of Ozone 9 Standard and Advanced, we've added a track referencing feature that can load, manage, and audition reference tracks without any additional setup in your DAW. Having Ozone on your master bus or firing up the standalone app is all you need to do to quickly A/B your track with up to 10 references. Access the referencing panel by clicking on the reference button below the IO meters. Click on the plus button next to the empty reference track tab to select a reference track from your file directory to load into Ozone 9. When you first load a reference track into Ozone, we run a segmentation algorithm to detect segments of material to give you suggested loop points, like verses and choruses, for fast access to song sections. This allows you to find the most relevant section of your reference, i.e., the song section most like your own track, even faster. Each loop point is automatically given a letter of the alphabet as a default name corresponding to the sections that we detected in your track. Similar sounding sections will all be assigned the same letter so you can get going quickly. You can adjust loop points or section names from there. Settling loop points is very useful if you just want to compare, say, a reference's chorus to your own chorus, or even something as granular as the kick drum in a reference you love with the kick drum you're working on. From within the reference panel, click a tab to select one of your loaded reference tracks to audition and set its gain. From there, you can press the Reference A/B button and monitor your reference track. When you start playback with a reference track loaded, you will see two spectra overlaid in the spectrum meters. Personally, I like to change Ozone's spectrum meter settings to use the 3-second averaging. And I also find the third octave mode very useful when comparing the spectrum of my master with my reference. You can also use the meters in Ozone's I/O section to compare the level of your master with the reference track. By opening the I/O options pop-up, you can select Replace Input with Reference and view the reference track's level in the left meter in the I/O section. With those parameters in place, we can go to the EQ module, for example, and make moves to bring our source track closer to the reference. In fact, anywhere we have spectrum view in Ozone, we'll see both EQ traces, which will help us to bridge the gap between the source and the reference. Any of your loaded references can be used as a target for Master Assistant so that you can get to a great mastering starting point in 60 seconds or less. At the top of the plugin, you'll see the Master Assistant feature. Master Assistant is designed to give you a starting point that is intelligently tailored to your music to help you create a professional sounding master regardless of your experience level. First, choose a vibe you'd like. Choosing modern applies the non-vintage modules in Ozone to your track, giving your track a more contemporary, clean tone. Choosing vintage applies the vintage modules, imparting a warm analog vibe. Next, choose reference, and then select the song you'd like to make the track you're working on sound like. Once you've identified the reference track and choose the destination, press next, and make sure you're playing the loudest portion of the track that you're working on. Now, Master Assistant will go to work to make your track sound like the reference by calculating the EQ curve and the loudness of the reference and imposing those characteristics over your source track so that your source track has the same tone and loudness as the reference. The Match EQ module is a digital linear phase EQ with the ability to use over 8,000 bands of frequencies for very precise reference matching. So if there's an EQ profile out there that you love, Ozone will learn it and let you transfer it onto the track that you're working with. To capture a reference snapshot from a song loaded into the referencing panel, follow these steps. Step 1. Open the referencing panel by clicking Reference. Load the song you want to capture a snapshot of, and enable reference playback with the power button. Step 2. Switch back to the Match EQ module. Press play in your DAW and click the capture button. You should hear your reference track playback and see a spectrum snapshot start to build. Once the spectrum settles, click stop in the reference capture panel. Stop your DAW and turn off the reference panel. Now we need to capture a spectrum of the track that we're working on. So I'll make sure that I have playback from my DAW and press the capture button here. The capture curve will be shown in blue in the view display. The reference, as we saw, is in yellow. Now we see a new line emerge in white. This is our matched curve. We can adjust the matched curve settings to designate the amount and smoothing of the matched white curve. You can adjust the action region by clicking on a range selector and dragging the range selector right or left across the display. So if you really love the low end of your reference and want to bring its magic to only the low end of your track, narrow the bands to apply the magic there and only there. And a pro tip, once you've captured a bunch of references and saved them as presets, you can then capture a snapshot of your song and scan through your reference presets to find the one that really works best to bring out the character and vibe that you're after. The updated Tonal Balance Control is a referencing powerhouse. It's designed to help you locate and fix frequencies in your mix that may be out of balance, so that your audio can sound great in any listening environment. View high, mid, and low frequency areas against targets based on genre or on your own uploaded reference tracks. iZotope created genre-specific targets by analyzing thousands of incredible masters, which you can call up here to select and reference against. However, you can always upload your own individual references or whole folder of references like this. And let's say you notice an abundance or deficit of energy in a particular region. Thanks to a protocol that we developed called inter-plugin communication, you can adjust the gain or EQ on other iZotope plugins by calling them up here directly from the Tonal Balance Control window while viewing the changes against your reference target. So if I'm noticing an abundance of energy happening on the high end, I could call up Ozone's EQ and make a move that will reduce the energy in that region, contributing to an overall healthier tonal balance. Watch. thank you so much for watching. Be sure to check out our other videos on mixing and mastering and head to iZotope.com for more information on referencing. Take care.